and welcome to the fabulous Yas Marina circuit here in Abu Dhabi, the location for this year's Young Driver Test. Over the next 2 days, we'll go behind the scenes as we watch the teams put the next generation of potential Formula One drivers through a series of tests to
Hey, good to see you again. As your race engineer, it's my job to support you this weekend. When you're out on track or remain in contact via radio, I'll feed you information as and when you need it. As discussed in the team briefing, we're not looking for outright speed to begin with, so just take your time. Follow my instructions and you'll do great. I'll just check the lads are ready. Attach comms when you're in the car. Okay, let's get you strapped in.
Okay, let's run through the basic controls and ensure the guys have set the car correctly so that you're comfortable. First, let's check that the accelerator and brake pedals are a good fit. Great, let's check the steering lock next. Move the wheel from left to right for me. Next up are the gears. The box is either manual or automatic, but you can override the auto at any time by using the gear up and down controls. Pull the right paddle to go up a gear, and the left paddle to come down. Okay, everything looks good. Let's head out on track and complete some tests. All set. Okay, before we start, I want to let you know that you can change the camera position by pressing the change camera button. Try cycling through them until you find the one you like. If you want to change your camera or assists, you can do it from the pause menu whenever you want. The first test is a simple straight line aero test. Head down the track, accelerating past 160 miles per hour, then brake, so that you come to a complete stop in the designated area. The engine is locked to lean, so it's down a little on power at the moment, but it'll give us a consistent reading. The first test. and you're on the brakes at just the right time.
Formula One cars have around 750 brake horsepower being sent to the rear wheels. The delivery can be very violent, so you must be careful to be smooth and precise with all your inputs so that you don't unsettle the car and cause a spin. At speed, the car's aerodynamics generate a lot of downforce, forcing the car to the track. To work efficiently with downforce, you should put a lot of force into the brake pedal initially, slowly reducing the pressure as they turn in for the corner, as you'll have less grip at this stage and be asking the tyres to work harder. When navigating a corner, stay as wide as possible before sweeping in to clip the corner's apex, taking as straight a line as possible. This allows you to get on the accelerator earlier and straighten up the car on the exit of the corner, slowly increasing the pressure on the accelerator as you exit the corner until you're confident the rear wheels will no longer spin, at which point you can use full power.
Towards the hairpin corner, turn in at the correct point, hit the apex, and accelerate past 185 miles per hour out of the corner. Together a couple of corners. Turn in so you hit the corner's apex and get on the gas early as you exit. We need you to stop in a designated area at the end of the straight to complete. view of the apex is. You might want to give it another go. Okay.
Kinetic Energy Recovery System, better known as KERS, allows drivers to deliver an additional 80 bhp of power at the press of a button. KERS can be used at any time in any session and can be used for overtaking or defending. Deploying KERS in the low gears gives the best return and can pay off greatly when used at the start. KERS works by collecting the kinetic energy released under braking and storing the charge. Drivers are allowed 7 seconds of charge per lap. The KERS system can at times develop faults. These can be fixed while the driver is still out on track. DRS adjusts the angle of the rear wing, which reduces drag and gives around 10 to 12 kmh extra top speed. For safety reasons, DRS can only ever be used in the defined activation points. During a race, you'll need to be within 1 second of the car ahead to activate the DRS.
Okay, before we start, I want you to perform a quick systems check for KERS and DRS. Press and hold the KERS button for me, please. Great. Now try activating the DRS. Press it once to open it and a second time to close it. Alternatively, you can press the brake to close it. Okay, you've got a car ahead of you who looks to be practicing their race start. I want you to use both your KERS and DRS to try and overtake them before you cross the finish line up ahead. Whatever you do, don't collide with them. Good luck. Okay, you've got 3 cars ahead of you. Use your... Yeah. it with another driver. Try again. Okay, you've got three.
There are four tyre types available during a race weekend: primes, options, intermediates and wets. Prime tyres will last the longest but have less overall grip than the option tyres. However, the increased grip from the options means they wear out faster. Intermediates are best used when the track is damp, and wets should only be used in heavy rain. The best drivers don't take too much life out of their tyres. This allows them to have more race strategies open to them, as well as allowing them to run tyres with more grip for longer. The best way to avoid excessive tyre wear is by being smooth with your throttle, brake and steering inputs, and avoiding sliding the car out of corners and causing wheel spin, which will destroy tyre life.
Excellent work, that's the end of day one.